my dear children. Today I've come up with an exceptional story, that is a documentary story. Documentary story means a real life based story or the fact basis story. The title of the story is My Early Days with the Chimpanzees. The story of a woman and the chimpanzees. So let's start the story. On July 16, 1960 was the day when Jane stepped in Gombe National Stream Park in Tanzania for the first time to observe and study about chimpanzees. She was accompanied by her mother. Every morning, Jane woke up when she heard alarm clock at 5:30. She ate her breakfast and then set off the place where the chimps might be. Most often, she went to the peak from where she could observe the chimps. In the beginning, she observed chimps through her binoculars and never tried to get close. She knew if she did so, they would run. Slowly she began to learn about them, their house, how they lived there. Most of the time, what she discovered was chimps stay in a small group of six or less. Often little group was made up of a mother with her children. Two or more adult males by themselves. Sometimes many groups joined together, especially when there was delicious ripe fruits and they enjoy. Then Jane also learned and observed about what types of leaves, flowers, fruits and other food they eat. Gradually, chimps began to realize that Jane was not so frightening after all. As time passed by, she learned about more creatures in Gombe Forest. Four kinds of monkeys, squirrels, mongoose, porcupine, civet, rats and mice of all kinds, buffaloes, leopard, and poisonous snakes. Most of the time, Jane was into discovering about chimps. The peak from where she observed the chimps began to feel like her home. She began to spend her night up there in the peak and she loved to be there observing the chimps. Sleeping habits of the chimps. Jane learned how the chimpanzees make their bed and sleep. One more thing she had also learned was the infants sleep with their mother until they were up to 5 years of age or until the next baby is born. When Jane returned to her tent, she explained to her mother what she had seen that day, and her mother would also tell her what she had been doing there. Jane's mother had set up a small clinic where people come and get the treatment. Jane's mother and Jane herself were very helpful and helped many local people out there. After 4 months, her mother went to England to manage things at home. Jane missed her, but there was no time to feel lonely. There was so much to do in life as she was just 26 years old woman and untrained primatologist. Primatologist, the one who study about primates, the human-like wild mammals, such as monkeys, chimpanzees, and other apes. So next, I would like to share a short documentary video of Jane Goodall and her researches on chimpanzees. So enjoy the video.
July 14th, 1960. 26-year-old Jane Goodall arrives on the shores of Gombe Stream Game Reserve on the coast of what is now Tanzania.
When I looked at the wild and rugged mountains where the chimpanzees lived, I knew that my task was not going to be easy.
She had been sent by renowned anthropologist Dr. Louis Leakey, who then approached the National Geographic Society about supporting Jane's work. She has no field experience or college degree. What she has is determination to observe chimpanzees with a mind uncluttered by conventional scientific methods.
When I first came to Gombe to study chimpanzees, I knew nothing about them. Nobody really knew very much about them.
She also has the courage to spend months in a remote, even dangerous place, getting closer to wild chimps than anyone before her. Within weeks, she is making astonishing discoveries. Chimps will hunt down large mammals and eat them. And more shocking, they not only use tools, but make them as well.
The chimpanzee is actually modifying a natural object to suit it to a specific purpose, thus making a tool.
When Louis Leakey first heard about tool using at Gombe, he got extremely excited and said, "Now we have to redefine man, redefine tool, or include chimpanzees with humans."
These discoveries, caught on film, sent National Geographic into a flurry of coverage. In the next 5 years, National Geographic presents Jane's first film and many articles in the magazine. Jane becomes a star. She and her beloved chimps, David Graybeard, Flo, and Flint, become known worldwide. And Jane redefines science, adding an emotional component.
It's perfectly possible to be incredibly emotionally involved, feeling great empathy for your subject.
It's what would drive Jane to learn as much about chimps as anyone in the world, to find out how alike we really are.
During the very early years, I thought how like people they were, but they seemed to be much more gentle, much nicer. But then it became more and more apparent that chimpanzees, like humans, have a dark side to their nature.
She witnesses a war between chimpanzees that lasts 4 years. Decades deep in her study, Jane discovers that the chimp populations are under threat from the outside. By the 1980s, they are an endangered species. Jane realizes she can best save these creatures by leaving Gombe to speak to the world face to face about the importance of protecting these chimps.
If we just sit back and allow the chimpanzees here and everywhere else to become extinct, it'll be an enormous black mark on us as a species. As we destroy the natural world, we end up with a situation where the people are suffering. So there has to be a way of creating a balance between humans and the natural world.
Gombe has since become a national reserve, and Jane's sights are set on the future.
Killer,
jungle.
She has launched conservation projects, humanitarian work. The Jane Goodall Institute is promoting a new generation of conservationists.
Oh, wow, nice.
And helping to mentor a new generation of chimp researchers.
And I'm going to do everything I can to cheer them on, because that, I think, is the only hope.
50 years later, Jane has witnessed the lives of three generations of chimpanzees. The dream that Jane Goodall set in motion lives on, and her partnership with National Geographic continues. The October issue of National Geographic magazine features a celebration of the young English girl who was a pioneer in so many ways, who patiently reached across every boundary to draw us closer to our closest relatives.
So, how's the video, children? Did you enjoy watching it? I hope this video will surely helps you in learning the lessons. Thank you.